present to you.
Welcome back to Recappy. Today we are going to recap a 2007 horror thriller movie titled P2. When a businesswoman ends up working late on Christmas Eve, she becomes trapped in a parking garage. The security guard, who is a psychopath, poses a significant threat to her, and it continues to build a strolling plot to the story. But before we begin, please consider subscribing to this channel. Now, without wasting any further time, let's begin, shall we? Angela is working on a business transaction with clients on Christmas Eve. Jody, a co-worker, approaches to give assistance, but Angela urges her to go home. Jim, Angela's other co-worker, comes to apologize for pestering her the day before while he was inebriated. Angela forgives him because she no longer wants to cope with the problem. Angela phones her family and assures them that she will be home for dinner on time. She finishes her duties a few hours later and meets Carl, the company's security guard, in the lobby. Angela pulls up to the parking lot and tries to start her car, only to discover that it won't start. Angela decides to return to the lobby and hail a taxi, but the company's doors have all been shut. Angela approaches the security office and requests permission to enter. As Angela answers the door, Rocky, a Rottweiler dog, barks at her. The dog's owner, Thomas, tries to calm him down. Angela advises Thomas that she needs to order a taxi, knowing how difficult it will be to find a cab on Christmas Eve. Thomas offers to help Angela charge her car battery. Angela pauses for a bit before agreeing to give the concept a try. However, after a while, Angela realizes that this will take some time. She thanks Thomas for his efforts and requests entrance to the lobby once more. Angela thanks him once again and bids him farewell as the door opens. Angela falls asleep after calling for a taxi, but the driver wakes her up shortly after the taxi arrives. Carl has also locked the main door, which Angela observes. Angela is still attempting to contact for aid at level P1 when the driver grows bored of waiting. Angela uses the light from her phone to get to her car at P2 like one would in a dark environment when the parking light goes out. Angela trips, and her belongings are strewn about. Behind her, a figure arrived, and it was Thomas, who was standing there waiting for her. He struck when the timing was right. Angela fell asleep for the second time that night after he covered her nose and mouth with a chloroform handkerchief. Angela is dressed in a new outfit as she wakes up. As a result of the chloroform, she vomits on the carpet. She discovers her legs are tethered to the table and inquires, "What are you looking for?" Thomas continues to wax lyrical about himself. Thomas stated that he is solely interested in learning where she is from. Thomas pours a glass of wine. Thomas claims that he is assisting Angela in order for her to be able to enjoy her alone time. Angela then warns Thomas that her boyfriend will look for her if she does not return home soon. Thomas notices her deception and tells Angela to deceive her family as well. When she successfully informs her family that she won't be able to attend the dinner because she is sick, Thomas rewards her by taking her on a drive. While he unties the restraints on her ankles, Angela snatches the dagger and stabs Thomas in the back. Unfortunately, Thomas is able to stop Angela from fleeing. He puts her in handcuffs and leads her to the car. While Thomas transports Angela to P4, she's perplexed. Jim, Angela's other co-worker described earlier, is seated in a wheelchair, his mouth, wrists, and feet strapped up, and Thomas brings her to the present he has arranged for her. Thomas hands Angela a baton and tells her that she is to teach Jim a lesson. When Angela begs Thomas not to hurt Jim, Thomas becomes infuriated. Angela decides that defeating Jim is preferable. And then she manages to flee, so she accepts. Thomas, on the other hand, remembered that he was going to psychologically destroy Angela, so he changed his mind and went ahead and did it himself. After smashing Jim's face, Thomas returns to the automobile. Angela takes advantage of the opportunity to go by ramming Jim with her vehicle and smashing him against the wall, while Thomas hides Jim's body. She goes back to Thomas' office to retrieve her phone and access card. He must have known exactly where he hid them. Thomas contacts Angela at the same moment. She phones the emergency number 911. Angela manages to flee just in time before Thomas catches up with her. After opening the lobby door, Angela is allowed to enter the elevator. She discovers that the lift requires a key, so she presses the emergency call button on the elevator. Someone answers Angela's call on the other end of the line. It's Thomas. Angela informs Thomas that she has phoned the cops and will wait for them in the elevator. Angela is forced to exit the elevator from the top floor by Thomas. He floods the lift with a fire hose from a higher floor. Carl's body falls from the ceiling as the elevator fills with water. After that, Angela decides to leave. She takes refuge beneath one of the automobiles, soaking in the cold. Thomas notices Angela's wet tracks and starts walking in them. When Thomas hears Angela's frightened voice, he slams the car's tires together, forcing Angela to flee yet again. This time, Thomas does not pursue her. Instead, he watches her through the security camera in his office while listening to Elvis. While on her approach to Thomas's office, Angela pulls out an emergency fire axe and begins destroying the surveillance cameras. Angela is shown a video of herself passing out when she arrives at Thomas's office. Thomas also dressed her and touched her naked body. Angela shatters the television and then observes two cops. Thomas tased her from behind without missing a beat. Drunk Thomas approaches the two police officers after changing his clothes and hiding Angela in her. The officer examines the entire parking lot and comes home empty-handed. Angela quickly reawakens to find herself stuck in the trunk of her automobile. She flees and rushes to catch the cops before they leave, only to be met at the door by Thomas and Rocky. Angela runs again after Thomas releases Rocky's leash, and the chase begins. Angela hides by smashing one of the rental car's windows. When Rocky discovers Angela, she kills the dog with the weapon she's holding. Angela staggers over to a local rental car company and dials 911. Thomas pursues her, but she manages to spray him with something poisonous. Angela almost makes it to the exit door in one of the rental cars before getting hit from the side by Thomas. The hunt continues and concludes with Angela triumphant. During the chase, she, on the other hand, flips the car and is knocked out. Thomas tries to help her by opening the door, but she stabs him in the eye with an envelope opener. And then she uncuffs herself so she may handcuff him to the smashed car with his keys, suffocating him with her handcuff chains. Thomas panics even more when he sees his taser in Angela's hand and the gasoline in the car begins to flow. Thomas apologizes and inquires as to why they are unable to spend more time together. Angela had had enough of Thomas's explanations and started walking away until he yelled at her and called her a stupid fucking cunt. Angela reconsiders and approaches him. "Merry Christmas, Thomas," she says as she ignites the gasoline with a taser, engulfing the automobile in flames and engulfing Thomas. Before turning around and leaving, she stands there for a minute, watching him burn and listening to his screams. And this is where the movie comes to an end. I hope you enjoyed it, as always until next time.